Hey, everyone. Welcome back. We are still on the road here at Chipstock Roadshow. It's ASML earnings week, so we wanted to get out a quick update on their Q3 2023 results.
Yeah, Casey, I think it's important at this point because we got the preliminary look at 2024 and a very, very preliminary, I don't even want to call it guidance, but maybe brief update on what to expect for 2025. So we wanted to give you all some expectations that we're looking for, some assumptions that we're making in valuing ASML stock, and what we're going to do with our holding in this very, very crucial part of the semiconductor industry. Why don't you hit us with the Q3 highlights? Before continuing, let me remind you to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if this video is helpful as you do your own investment research and increase your knowledge of business and technology. We really appreciate the support as subscribing to the channel helps us continue putting out content like this.
It will just show you the slide from the investor presentation. Net sales, 6.7 billion euros. Net system sales of 5.3 billion euros. And installed base management sales of 1.4 billion euros. Gross margin, nearly 52%. Operating margin, 32.7%. Earnings per share, €4.81. And net bookings of 2.6 billion euros. And that includes an EUV booking of €500 million.
Yeah. So basically what that means is probably just three EUV machines booked in Q3. Let's talk about the net system sales breakdown for Q3. So Casey, we've actually been talking about this quite a bit the last few weeks here as we've discussed ASML. And I think this is not a surprise. This shouldn't be a surprise. We're going to go through the top row of these pie charts for ASML. RFI, so that's the argon fluoride immersion, the wet lithography systems, DUV systems, 48% of system sales in Q3. EUV, just over one third of the pie. And you can see memory still pretty depressed. Most of the sales going to logic chip makers. So think TSMC versus memory being Samsung, SK Hynix, and Micron. So Roger Dawson said on the prepared remarks, memory is still quite depressed, and we're probably not going to get a better growth inflection point for memory until sometime in 2024 for memory. Logic still carrying the load. And specifically, you can also see China at 46% of sales, up from 24% just last quarter. That looks really, really concerning. But remember, this is absolutely to be expected. We called this out over the last 2 months. China, they had a bunch of backlog starting in 2022. And it looks like a lot of those orders for DUV machines, because remember, EUV is off limits to China because of export controls. So accelerated orders for DUV, because some of those wet DUV immersion lithography systems are going to be off limits without an export license starting January 1st, 2024. So China accelerating those orders, and that's what's happening here. That's why there's the big jump in sales to China.
ASML reiterated that they would have a 30% revenue growth in 2023, that would put them about $27.5 to $28 billion in revenue for 2023. And we would like to point out one more thing here on the capital return to shareholders. In Q3, ASML paid out an interim dividend of €1.45 per ordinary share, and pair that with the Q3 share repurchase of around 100 million euros. That's a pretty solid quarter.
Yeah, it looks like their shareholder returns in 2023, it is on pace to far exceed what they returned in 2022. Now, we would like to have seen more share repurchases in 2022 when the stock was depressed. But at the end of the day, you can see from the chart here, ASML still making really great progress, increasing their shareholder returns consistently each year. So that's the good news. And really, really fantastic growth for 2023. Now, Casey, let's pull some comments from Chief Financial Officer Roger Dawson, specifically this comment on 2024. Again, this is a preliminary guide, but they're being cautious given that they don't know exactly what their customers are going to have in store for 2024. It looks like the semiconductor industry is bottoming here, but they're not sure what the shape of the recovery curve is going to be in 2024. Roger Dawson says they're modeling for flat-ish revenue in 2024. That actually jives pretty well with the decreasing bookings ASML has been receiving as of late. As you mentioned, Casey, just 2.6 billion euro. So we're headed towards closer to 30 billion euro in backlog by the time we exit 2023.
As we mentioned in a recent video, the EUV machine is not what's driving sales at ASML. We'll show you another slide here from the presentation regarding the mature markets that DUV machines make the chips for. You have power, mature, logic, and analog sensors. In 2023, 2024, we're probably going to be seeing the same going forward. And it won't be until 2025 that we'll see that rebound or possible rebound in the EUV machine made chips.
Yeah, Casey, this is an important couple of slides here. What we're actually doing is we're pulling from the November 2022 Investor Day. And we want to take a moment and review this with you because the assumption now at this point is flat-ish sales for 2024 for ASML. We're modeling that they're going to have about 28 to 29 billion in revenue next year, assuming that kind of flat-ish, cautious outlook. Given that Roger Dawson said that they think 2024 is now going to be a transition year, so more DUV, less EUV, but then in 2025, they're expecting significant growth as more EUV machines get installed at their customers and start driving more of those advanced logic chips beyond what is being made right now. So let's review this November 2022 presentation where they gave their long-term updated outlook. And you can see what we're talking about here. In that middle light blue column, you can see the high NA EUV machines. By 2025, only five of them is what their projection was, but at 300 to 400 million euro a pop at each machine, that will start to contribute some significant revenue, but not until 2025. You can see the current EUV machine, 65 to 80 units, still not the driving force for ASML. And you can see that ARFI, argon fluoride immersion systems, and dry lithography systems still contributing the biggest portion of revenue. Moving over to the right-hand side, still those light blue columns, the revenue range that they projected for 2025, 30 billion to 40 billion euro. Given that 2024 is expected to be a flat-ish year at, again, for our modeling purposes, we're thinking somewhere between 28 and 29 billion euro in revenue. We think for 2025, just to be conservative here, we should start to model for somewhere between 30 and 35 billion euro in revenue. Given the base that ASML is working off of, we think that 40 billion high-end projection for total sales is way too aggressive, given how deep this semiconductor downturn has been and how long it's taking ASML's customers to recover. So again, we're modeling for somewhere in the range of 30 to 35 billion. Let's split the difference and say about 33 billion euro in sales for 2025. We think this is going to trend towards the low end of that guidance provided in November 2022.
Nick, in our last video, we put the valuation at 31 times trailing 12 months earnings per share. What would you say the valuation is on a forward-looking basis?
Okay, so they reiterated 2023 guidance for 30% revenue growth. That puts us on track by the time they report Q4 earnings in another 3 months at about 27 to 28 times earnings for full year 2023. And then if we assume flattish revenue growth and maybe just mid-single digit earnings per share growth because of those stock buybacks, maybe a little bit of margin expansion next year, maybe 26, maybe 25 times expected 2024 earnings, we're going to go with 26 times expected earnings for 2024. And then out into 2025, if they get up to say 33 billion euro, we're thinking that maybe pushes ASML stock down to maybe 20 times 2025 earnings per share. That's just our model that we're projecting for about 20 times earnings per share for 2025. So given this update, we think it's a good time to be a bit cautious with ASML stock. We were buyers during this dip, and we think this is still something that would be a good dollar cost average candidate for most investors. We think that there's going to be a lot of volatility in the next year and a half until some of those orders come rolling in and refill the backlog of orders for ASML headed into 2025. We think it's going to happen because there are, remember, dozens of new fabs and fab upgrades taking place around the world. Inevitably, those customers that are conserving cash right now are going to need those lithography machines. But this is just a timing thing. And because of that timing, we think that 2025 outlook is maybe going to come in a bit lower than once anticipated. We don't see any imminent reason to go out and purchase a ton of ASML stock.
In the last 3 months, ASML stock price has been as high as 750 and as low as 560, 570. And we expect it to continue to trade the $550 to $600 range going forward for the time being.
Yeah, unfortunately, folks, you know, this Q3 was a fantastic quarter, great year-over-year growth. But remember, it's the forward guidance that matters most when valuing a stock. So that's what we're looking at. Mm-hmm. Still a fantastic company. We love ASML, and they're going to sell a lot of machines over the course of the next 5 to 7 years. We're happy with the position we have, and maybe we'll take a look at nibbling some more before the end of the year. Stay tuned.
Make sure you hit the subscribe button and don't miss a video. We have earnings season ramping up. We have Lam Research and Taiwan Semiconductor coming up later this week and many more. It's just getting started. So we will see you all again very soon at ChipStock Investor.